Johnson just arrived to the club now.
Hello, good morning. Sorry for the delay.
Good morning, sir.
How many members are there? 8 members, okay. So I think tomorrow we'll finish this classes, and tomorrow will be the last class. Tomorrow I may take classes. Today I'll take only one class because I have to have some other. So let us start the class, and we were talking about behavioral performance management for the optimization or for the maximization of the performance. And mute everybody, right? Okay, I'll mute all the people and so yesterday we have seen three theories. Number one, classical conditioning, and number two, operant conditioning, and number three, the social learning theory. Social learning theory. So classical conditioning was proposed by Ian Pavlos, and according to his theory, our behavior is a function of the stimulus that is produced in us. So that's why it is called SR theory, stimulus response. This is classical conditioning. Then we have seen operant conditioning, which is opposite of classical conditioning. It is not a stimulus that produces response, but it is the consequence that determines the response, or the stimulus produced by the consequence that determines the response. So in operant conditioning theory, we have seen four important categories in the reinforcement: positive reinforcement, negative reinforcement, punishment, and extreme. What is reinforcement? Repetition. Repetition. Sometimes, you know, we get certain habits. How do we get habits? We will be going on repeating certain actions. We'll be repeating certain actions. And those actions will, we can call that they are reinforced. That means they are repeated again and again. So we have seen positive, what is positive reinforcement, what is negative reinforcement, and what is punishment, and how punishment is not so effective. It has to be administered carefully, otherwise it will be lose-lose situation. And when the stimulus has no response on us, stimulus has no influence on us, we call that as extinction. And then we moved on to see another important theory called social cognitive theory. What Pavlov said, within us there is a stimulus that will determine our behavior. What Skinner said, it is not inner stimulus but outside consequence that will determine our behavior. Now Bandura, what he proposed is, In agreement with the other two theories, he proposed that people's behavior is a function of what they observe in the society. In the society around them, what they observe and the models they take in the society. So we symbolize, we think about that, and we depend on the previous consequence, that is vicarious modeling, and we regulate ourselves and we reflect on ourselves. So behavior can be learned, behavior can be regulated. And in social learning theory, self-efficacy plays a major role, because self-efficacy is very, very important. That means believing in your ability is very, very important, is very important. So self-efficacy plays a major role. So now, what are the different reinforcers? And how, suppose an employee is working hard and working very efficiently. My question as a manager is, how I can make him to repeat the same behavior, same performance in over a period of time? How I can do that? That is called reinforcing the behavior. How I can make, so for example, one student is studying well, working hard. Now, how I can make him to continue that without losing the motivation? So there we studied in the already in the first unit, that is, it is a repetition of that, reward systems. In the reward, the first category is money as a reward. So money as a reinforcer. We have seen base pay technique, that means increasing the salary, but that has a very bad effect. So we thought about pay for performance. So these are money is very much essential and very much motivating. And Jock Welch, who is a former GE head, he told, money is that matters. Check can be cashed, but if you give any memento, that will gather dust. That's what he told. So money plays a major effective role as a reinforcer. You give money, people will go on doing the work. But it is very important, how do we address that? How do we administer this money as a reward that we have seen in the first unit? You cannot go on increasing the salary. That will have a negative effect on others. So you have to quantize the work done. Then second category, non-financial rewards. First one is finance or money as a reinforcer. What is reinforcing? The thing which makes the person to repeat the same thing. So in non-financial reward, there are many categories, you know. Earlier in software industry, people used to give coupons, supermarket coupons. They can go and get the coupons. But I think nowadays nobody are giving those coupons. So consumables, free lunch, food basket, hams, Christmas turkeys, dinner for family, company picnics, after work parties, time off, trips, entertainment, sports event, educational classes, all these are consumable. Next, manipulatables, which will desk accessories, something like, you know, a pen, a watch, an alarm clock, and wall plaques, company car, watches, trophies, commendations, rings, ties, pens, pins, tie pins, appliances, furniture for the home, PC, computer for home, laptop, home shop tools, garden tools, clothing, clubs, use of company recreation facilities, convenience center, use of company facilities for personal projects. All these are manipulatables. Then visual and auditory. Office with a window, music, internet, email, personal use, redecoration of work environment, work environment, company, literature, private office, popular speakers or lectures, book club, discussions, all these are visual and auditory. Job design job with more responsibility, job rotation, special assignment, cross training, on site knowledge training, authority to schedule own work in flexible timings. You can come at any time, flexible hours, flexible breaks, job sharing, participation in discussion, participating in teams, self-managed teams. These are job design. Then formal recognition, formal acknowledgement, achievement, feature in in-house newsletter, story in newspaper, celebrations, banquets, letter of commendation, acknowledgement, praising in front of others in staff meeting or in team meeting. That is formal recognition. Non-verbal feedback, performance, non-verbal performance information, verbal performance, written reports, appraisals, charts, counters, self-information. Then social recognition, friendly greetings, solicitation of suggestions, advice, compliment of work progress, pat on the back with a smile, wonderful, how, very good, excellent. This type of verbal recognition or praise. So these are the 9 non-financial rewards that can motivate the worker or the employee. In other words, reinforcer. Now coming to the social recognition and attention, this has to be very careful. Otherwise, what will happen is, you know, sometimes if you do it with insincerity, you know, you pat a back of person with insincerity, that will have a negative effect. And then people can understand whether you are doing it genuinely or manipulatingly. So social recognition should be genuine. It should be valued. Otherwise, people will get used to it and they will not take it as a motivator or a reinforcer. It will have a negative effect. Now, another important thing is organizational behavior model or modification model. This way, this I will keep it as mod. So how to, how to modify behavior of a person or an employee in the organization. So our textbook author, Ludens, has proposed a model. So this is organizational behavior modification. MOD is for modification. Model. This is a model for behavior performance management. So this is a complex diagram, but I'll come to it later because if you read this here. So there are 5 important steps. Very simple. You need not worry about the complexity of it. 5 important steps. Number 1, identify. First, you should identify what are the performance-related behavioral events which can be modified, which can be quantified, which can be qualified, or which are important. First, you have to identify the performance-related behavioral events. The quantity or quality of producing the products or delivering service by operating employees. First thing is, number 1, remember the side heading, identifying the behavior. Number 2, once you identify, you have to measure the performance. Performance behaviors identified in the first step ought to be measured under the existing conditions. This is called baseline measurement. How often, what is the frequency of this behavior? For example, one person is regularly absent for the work. So you have to identify who are absent. Number 2, you have to take out the details, analyze. What is the frequency of absenteeism? What is the frequency of absenteeism? That is the baseline measure. Once you measure, you have to analyze what is the reason, what is the consequence, and how to change this behavior. You have to analyze. Number one, identify. Number two, measure. Number three, analyze. Number four, then you have to intervene. You have to, you have to take some action. Here we take some action step of organizational behavioral modification model. So the goal is to accelerate functional performance behaviors. Well, if it is a good performance, we want to accelerate it. If it is a bad performance, we want to decelerate it. And if it is dysfunctional, we want to minimize the frequency. So then you may think of positive reinforcement such as monetary, non-financial, social recognition, attention, feedback, those things. Then finally, you have to evaluate those things. If it is satisfactory, you can go to other. Otherwise, you have to go back. This is what the first slide talks about. So you have to identify by the behavior changes. What are observable, what is measurable, task related, critical to the task. Observance and very things. These things have to be identified. Once you identify the measure, how to measure, direct observation, time sampling, auditing the data, taking the history data, historical data, archives data, these things you have to analyze in the time. What is the percentage? Number three, analyze. Functional antecedents. What are the reasons for the behavior? Here, A, B, C. A means antecedent, and the reason for the behavior. And C, the consequence. B is for behavior. This is called ABC model analyzer. Once you analyze, you will intervene. You will come into picture. You will take action. So develop intervention, consider organizational context, industry, structure, size, process, technology, all those things. Then apply intervention, use positive reinforcement, financial, non-financial, social, combination of those three. Measure the frequency. If the behavior is modified, then maintain the modification. How to maintain the modification? Schedule the reinforcement, continuous, intermittent, and you can continue it. Otherwise, if the behavior is not modified, you can repeat intervene. Still it is modified, again go back to identify and do this. Then finally, evaluate. Once the behavior is modified, evaluate. So don't be terrified by the complexity of the diagram. Remember the five steps. Identify, measure, analyze, intervene, evaluate. And in analyze, ABC model. So identifying the behavior is very important. How to identify? You can take feedback from the supervisor. You can attach a person. You can take the behavior audit. And you can take feedback. And you can take the records. And you can identify by seeing the quality of the work. It can be done in two ways. One approach is to have the person closest to the job in question, immediate supervisor or actual job holder. Number two, behavioral audit. Audit would be very much useful. Sometimes internal staff will do audit. Sometimes outside auditors will do. Once you do this, second one is measurement of behavior. A baseline measurement is either by observing or counting or extracting for existing records, the number of times the identified behavior, for example, absenteeism or maximum performance, how many times he has done that within a time or within a week, what is the frequency? That is number three, functional analysis. Especially ABC model. A means antecedents. What is the reason? And then C means consequence, B is targeted behavior. So first we should know the reason, then we should analyze the consequence, then we can target the behavior B. It is ABC model. So for example, if you take attendance, one is coming regularly. What are the antecedents, reasons? Awareness of any consequence. Munda telusuntadi late pothe salary cut avutadi lekapothe late gelthe some punishment untadi, that type of things may there. Then what is the behavior? They will go to bed on time, and the consequent is reward programs. We may advertise that you have to come on time, people may set alarm. And the reward may be you can come early, or you can take contingent, urgent avasaram vaste you can come off. Meetings, waking up, memorandums, getting dressed. And these are the reasons. And manam chesetuvanti activities that will modify the behavior, and this is the consequence. So, leaving home early, getting a babysitter, driving to work, reporting to work. These are all behavior. Now, these are the behaviors for attendance, regular attendance. Now, some people will be absent. What are the attendance? What are the reasons? Illness or accident, hangover, ratri party chesukuntaru, morning levatam kashtam, lack of transportation, traffic. No daycare facility, pillalu untaru genuinely, there is no facility for them. Family problems, company policy, group or personal norms, seniority, age, awareness, observation. And what are the consequences? Discipline program, verbal reprimander, written memos, payment cut, dismissal, social consequence, and escape from and avoidance of working. So what is the reason for, what is the reason for this behavior? Getting up late, sleeping in late, staying at home, drinking, going to fishing or hunting, working at home, visiting, caring for a sick child. So you have to make this table A, B, C. What is the reason? What are the consequences? And what is the behavior? This is ABC of what, where, in which step we are? Number three, functional analysis. Functional analysis. So some, in this step, question may be asked to whether employee can do the identified performance behavior. Ante aa behavior meeda tana life depend ayunda ledha ani adagochu. Oka vela depend kaakapothe, అంటే ఒకవేళ ఆ జాబ్ మీదనే తను ఆధారపడలేదు అని చెప్పి అనుకుంటే అప్పుడు మనం ఇచ్చే బెనిఫిట్స్ వల్ల పెద్ద యూజ్ ఉండదు. ఓకే, దెన్ నంబర్ ఫోర్, ఇంటర్వెన్షన్ స్ట్రాటజీ. ఏం స్ట్రాటజీ చేస్తే, ఒకవేళ అబ్బాయి ఒకవేళ రెగ్యులర్ గా వస్తున్నాడు అనుకోండి, దట్ వీ వాంట్ టు రిపీట్. ఇర్రెగ్యులర్ గా వస్తున్నాడు అనుకోండి, వీ వాంట్ టు స్టాప్ దాట్, వీ వాంట్ టు డిసెలరేట్ దాట్. So what is the first thing? Positive reinforcement, not negative reinforcement. Positive reinforcement ki negative reinforcement ki difference enti? Anybody? Positive reinforcement ki negative reinforcement ki what is the difference? Salma? Okay. Manasa? Manasa?
Sir, sir.
What is the difference between positive reinforcement and negative reinforcement? Yesterday you were absent, right? Are you there?
Katya?
Hello? Renu Sri?
Sir, positive reinforcement ante positivity vastundi, motivation vastundi. But negative reinforcement ante suppose oka day off ichchar ankonde, inka laziness perugutundi.
లేజినెస్ కాదు, అక్కడ ఏంటంటే అక్కడ ఏదైతే అన్ప్లెజెంట్ థింగ్ ఉందో దాన్ని తీసేస్తాం. అక్కడ డే ఆఫ్ ఇయ్యటంలో కూడా మన ఉద్దేశం లేజినెస్ పెరుగుద్దని కాదు, తనని రెగ్యులర్ గా రమ్మని చెప్పడమే. బట్ తనకు ఆ ఫ్లెక్సిబిలిటీ ఇస్తాం, అంటే ఏంటంటే తనకి ఏదైతే ఇష్టం లేదో దాన్ని తొలగిస్తాం. దట్ ఈస్ నెగిటివ్ రీఎన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్. అంటే పాజిటివ్ రీఎన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్ కి నెగిటివ్ రీఎన్ఫోర్స్ రెండింటికి ఆబ్జెక్టివ్ ఒకటే, ఏంటి, we want to repeat the positive behavior. ippudu oka jail lo unna oka vyakti ni em daggistam, imprisonment time daggistam, that is negative ante vaadiki ishtam lendi teesestam, that is negative reinforcement. positive reinforcement ante vaadiki em ishtamo adi istam. rendittlo kuda mana uddesham entante on the positive sign only. okay, so now పాజిటివ్, యా గాట్ మై పాయింట్, పాజిటివ్ రీఎన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్, నెగిటివ్ రీఎన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్ రెండింటికి కూడా ఆబ్జెక్టివ్ ఒకటే, వీ వాంట్ టు మాక్సిమైజ్ ద పర్ఫార్మెన్స్. కొంతమందికి ఇచ్చి చేస్తాం, కొంతమందికి తీసేసి చేస్తాం. ఏం తీసేస్తాం, ఏదైతే వాడికి ఇష్టం లేదో అది తీసేస్తాం. సో ఇన్ ద ఇంటర్వెన్షన్ స్ట్రాటజీ ద ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ పాజిటివ్ రీఎన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్. మనం ఏమిస్తే, సపోజ్ ఇన్సెంటివ్ ఆర్ సమ్ ఇంక్రిమెంట్ ఆర్ సోషల్ రికగ్నిషన్, నాన్ ఫైనాన్షియల్, ఇప్పుడే మనం చూసాం నాన్ ఫైనాన్షియల్ అండ్ సోషల్ రికగ్నిషన్. సో వీ కెన్ ఇంటర్వీన్ అండ్ పాజిటివ్, నెగటివ్ అండ్ సమ్టైమ్స్ పనిష్మెంట్ మే ఆల్సో, సమ్టైమ్స్ పనిష్మెంట్ మే ఆల్సో బి యూస్డ్. సో పాజిటివ్ రీఎన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్ ఇక్కడ ఇఫ్ యు సీ, ఐ థింక్ దిస్ ఇస్ నాట్ మచ్ క్లియర్, బట్ మనీ, సోషల్ రికగ్నిషన్, మనీ అండ్ ఫీడ్బ్యాక్, సోషల్ రికగ్నిషన్ అండ్ ఫీడ్బ్యాక్, ఫీడ్బ్యాక్, మనీ అండ్ సోషల్ రికగ్నిషన్, దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ ద సక్సెస్. అంటే మనీ, సోషల్ రికగ్నిషన్, ఫీడ్బ్యాక్ మూడిటితో కంబైన్ చేస్తే వి గాట్ ద సక్సెస్ ఆఫ్ 90%. కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ మనీ, social recognition and feedback. So we can combine these three to get maximum success. Then punishment. Yesterday we discussed much about the punishment, but punished behavior only temporarily it will work, but punishment was never an option. We have to avoid punishment as much as possible, especially in the organization, because punishment reduces the productivity. The person will become anxious and he will reduce his productivity, and organization will lose as well as the person will lose. So punishment is not a good desirable thing. If punishment is very much necessary, then it should be positively reinforced at the first opportunity, then we can go for punishment. Then evaluation, whether our approach is effective or not. Evaluation to review. Who will review? Some vice presidents or corporate office or prospective primaries. They will sit as a team and they will evaluate what is the change in the person. So organizational behavior modification model attempts to meet the credibility and accountability problems head on by including evaluation as an actual part of the process. In evaluation, there are four levels of evaluation: reaction, learning, behavioral change, performance improvement. We should observe the reaction in evaluation. What oka oka work ivagane a reaction vastadi people lo, we have to see that reaction. how what type of reaction we can observe. Then learning, number 3 behavioral change, and number 4 performance improvement. Positive reaction vachind ankonde, that will ensure organizational support. They can provide planning feature programs and they can go ahead. Negative reaction vaste, we have to go back. So this is a very important model, and this model Luthan's organizational behavioral modification model, it is applied for increasing the employee productivity, reducing the absenteeism, safety and accident prevention, sales performance. So this is very important. So with this we close this class. We will meet tomorrow. With tomorrow our classes will end, and those who have not joined till now in the Google Classroom, please tell them to join and submit the assignment. Thank you very much for your time. See you. Take care. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow at 10 o'clock.